We live, baby. We live. Finish this mission. In massage, baby. So did it say before I opened the door?
God, look a little like you might save your skin.
I'm gonna find this armor. Can I still blow him up?
Sure, you'll manage all right.
This is my home. Quick, fucking sweat, Princess.
We make ammo. I would like to know. I don't know how much this meant, but we're just gonna make it all.
Enough of the senseless shootings that claim hundreds of innocents every day. I'm sick of the satire and empty and implant restriction dialogue. I'm tired of ignoring the cyberpsychosis problem. In American society today, there are still a lot of common myths and misconceptions about the so-called technology-related personality disorders. People think they can become infected in sketchy Ripper Doc clinics. Scientists allegedly disagree about the causes of the disease or even about whether it exists at all. Maybe their tune would change if a cyber psycho turned their lab into a slaughterhouse. But even then, I doubt it. They're not getting fat paychecks from the cyberware lobby just to openly declare to the public all the nasty possible side effects that came packaged with their products. Coronavirus vaccine. I've conducted my own research on cyberpsychosis. With supreme confidence, I can confirm this illness is indeed a byproduct of the modern lifestyle and the obsessive emphasis placed on incorporating modern tech into our lives. Although cybernetic implants can directly affect our brain chemistry, they still serve only as a catalyst for the onset of the disease. Our world is subject to extensive dehumanization. We surround ourselves with increasingly more automated machines and artificial intelligence. Our loved ones replace their nature-given eyes, lips, and faces with masks of metal. Some of us begin to lose sight of what is human. We slip into feelings of total alienation and deep-rooted panic. We lose the ability to distinguish between what is real and what is only artificial, digital, synthetic. Such people.
How are you feeling now?
Yeah. Such people begin to isolate themselves, lose their empathy for others, and undergo dramatic mood swings that exhibit sadistic tendencies. The most frightening component to all of this, however, is that most will never be diagnosed. Not all cyberpsychos are known war veterans or former mercenaries equipped with Sandifistian reflex tech. Not all will go out in a blaze of gunfire with Mox tech. Many cyberpsychos in our world possess only a single implant, a knee, a liver. They are unseen, unnoticed. They lock themselves up and shut out their friends, colleagues, and loved ones. The world outside of the net and their delusions has disappeared from conscious thought. They are sick and alone, and no one is doing a thing about it. There is no eloquent summary to be made here. Let the value of this manifesto be measured by the fact that I was expelled from the Zeta Tech Cybernetics research team for having written it. Wow.
There was some more ones to read, but it was all on your phone. You can wait till after this mission. The last one too, I think. Yeah.
Be bad.
3.5% unknown.
Water,
protein, fat. That's meat. Where meat is.
Percepts of Buddhism seem baffling to say the least. How would you explain to the average knight citizen why Bhikkhu, I don't know if I'm saying that right, such as yourself, are against implanting cybernetic technology into their bodies? Monks. It's not that we're against them per se. Every person has the right to make choices with their body so long as those choices don't harm another. Through Bhikkhu, whatever, do abide by stricter rules such as abstaining from cyberware in order to achieve enlightenment. Interviewer, then what does your hesitation stem from? How do cybernetics affect your pursuit of enlightenment? Well, short pause, among other things, it's their vague, fluid status. For lack of a better word, ask yourself, what is an implant? A part of your body, an impersonal object? Interviewer, you're asking me, unintelligible. Suppose I say it depends. Monk, precisely. Bhikkhu, whatever, limit their possessions to a robe, umbrella, and a bowl for alms. Everything else is a distraction that hinders his or her release from the world's suffering. Let's say, for example, that a synthetic hand is just that, a hand, a part of your body. But if it has a watch instilled in it, a blade, interviewer, right, I think I understand where the line's drawn isn't completely clear. Possessions, especially such intimate ones, are distractions that muddy the mind, that pull it further from inner peace. I believe the phenomenon of psychopsychosis is proof enough for this truth.
Just read about cyberpsychosis. Mm-hmm. Tell us something.
Take it. He's alive.
thought you'd never see me again, didn't you? Naive little punk.
So what now?
Maybe I should look into exactly what you did here. Today was about Royce getting his justice. Couldn't have done it without you. Flathead's yours. And consider us even.
I want a perimeter. Secure the area.
Time we were on our way.
Want to kill her?
Holy shit, Fee. Should we walk out of peace?
Think we're done. That's it.
Yeah, I had enough for one day. Hey, let Dex know we got his toy for him. And Fatso ought to crack open the bottle for us after what we did for him today. Hey, Lord, Obi.
You won't call me,
Why, Dave, is this the word for us? Got the line. And how did that go? Run into the trouble. And what about the military tank? Sure, of course, trouble. Boys, good to get you. I'm at stop. No doubt my mind's still be back in the trap. I don't feel bad, Dave. So, try to get that cowboy's hand over the flathead.
Only way I know it always works. You got some balls, Mr. B. We're all set. Ready to go. What now?
Now, we do the job I hired you to do. Grab that light chip. We'll talk about the rest at the afterlife. See you there.
Great. Be there in no time. See you, Mr. B.
Floating trash.
More I feel like I'm straight up lying.
Hmm?
But that's not done tomorrow.